The animosity being stoked by the Biden-Harris administration has reached unprecedented levels. Who exactly are these people and who do they truly represent? The images of caravans streaming through Mexico under the guise of immigration reveal something far more deliberate: the willful and systematic opening of our borders, leading to the undeniable invasion of the United States. Unfortunately, I still live in Fairfax County, which no longer resembles the place I once called home. It now looks as though Central America has moved in. In reality, it's not just Central America. It's also Haiti and countless other impoverished nations taking over US territories. Our southern border has collapsed, and the poorest nations on Earth are now flooding into the country. This isn't an accident, it's calculated politics. The goal isn't to help immigrants or better our nation. It's about importing pliable constituents to solidify the political elite's grip on power, even if it means undermining the citizens of this country. How can I say this with such conviction? Because there is no rational explanation for allowing 30 to 50 million illegal immigrants into our country without any means of assimilation. It's not immigration, it's an invasion.
It is wrong to somehow suggest that an undocumented immigrant is a criminal.
Being an undocumented immigrant is not a crime.
I know what a crime looks like. An undocumented immigrant is not a criminal. An undocumented immigrant is not a criminal.
An undocumented immigrant is not a criminal.
If you can twist logic enough to believe otherwise, you'll soon find yourself living in a version of hell right here in America. In Fairfax County, as taxes soar and schools crumble under the weight of an influx of non-English-speaking students, we see the consequences firsthand. A county once considered the pinnacle of American living is descending into chaos, mirroring the very countries from which these migrants are fleeing. This is why I say Central America and other nations are taking over the United States. It's not hyperbole, it's reality. Where is the US military in all of this? Supposedly the greatest military force on Earth, and yet incapable of protecting its own borders. Billions of dollars are sent overseas to protect the borders of other nations, while ours are left wide open, allowing impoverished countries to seize control of American soil. The once cherished idea of a nation of immigrants who assimilate into American culture has been twisted into a new reality, one where we're expected to surrender our culture and adopt foreign ones. Our children are no longer taught the Pledge of Allegiance. They're taught that America was built on imperialism, racism, and oppression.
Intifada, Intifada.
Intifada, Intifada.
Malcolm X said, and I quote, "We live in one of the rottenest countries that has ever existed on this earth. It's not Genocide Joe that has to go. It's the entire system that has to go."
The future we face is not one of American exceptionalism, but one of growing disdain for a nation that was once a global beacon of freedom and opportunity. Our founding documents, the Declaration of Independence, the Constitution, and the Bill of Rights, are being systematically distorted by the political elite. Their aim? To manipulate the public into accepting poverty, decay, and mediocrity as the new status quo. The strategy is both calculated and dangerous. By allowing unchecked illegal immigration, they inflate population numbers to reshape the political landscape in their favor. House seats in Congress are allocated based on population, regardless of whether individuals are here legally or not. This means political power can be shifted by an influx of illegal migrants, tipping the balance of representation without the consent of the governed. The founders, in their wisdom, could never have anticipated that political leaders would one day exploit an invasion of our borders to serve their own ambitions. What was once universally condemned as treasonous, a deliberate undermining of the nation's sovereignty, is now casually dismissed as just another policy dispute. The implications are far-reaching. The erosion of our principles, the weakening of our political system, and the slow dismantling of everything that once made this nation great. This isn't just about politics, it's about the future of the American Republic. We must recognize this strategy for what it is, a deliberate and coordinated effort to dilute the power of the citizenry and reframe the very concept of democracy itself.
There was an historic flood of undocumented immigrants coming across the border the first 3 years of your administration. As a matter of fact, arrivals quadrupled from the last year of President Trump. Was it a mistake to loosen the immigration policies as much as you did?
It's a long-standing problem, and solutions are at hand. And from day one, literally, we have been offering solutions.
What I was asking was it a mistake to kind of allow that flood to happen in the first place?
I think the policies that we have been proposing are about fixing a problem, not promoting a problem.
The truth is that these political leaders care nothing for the electorate they claim to represent. Their hypocrisy is blatant. I've had the misfortune of understanding how these people think. They're not concerned with your well-being. They see you as pawns, easily manipulated with cheap rhetoric and empty promises. If you're waiting for the utopia they claim to be building, I can assure you it won't be coming to your doorstep. Like the Germans who cheered as Hitler rose to power under the guise of socialism and equality, you too will realize too late that what's being built isn't a utopia. It's a living hell designed to benefit only a select few. Kamala Harris and Joe Biden aren't leaders. They're self-serving opportunists who enrich themselves and their inner circle at the expense of everyone else. They aren't even the ones in control. They're puppets for a globalist elite who have fully captured the Democratic Party. These elites have no interest in a world of shared abundance. They seek a world where they alone reap the rewards of everyone else's labor. It's time to wake up. What's happening is not the natural progression of a diverse and prosperous America. It's the engineered collapse of everything this nation was built on. If we continue down this path, the America we once knew will be nothing more than a distant memory.